Hello guys, in this session we will going to discuss about mechanical measurement in metrology lab. One more experiment, which is measurement of angle using bevel protractor. The measurement of angle using bevel protractor. The image what you are seeing, this is the bevel protractor. Using this device, we can able to measure the angle between the two components of a two faces of a component. The aim of this experiment, it is to find out the taper angle of given workpiece by using bevel protractor. The apparatus, surface plate, bevel protractor, taper, workpiece. So this is the parts of the vernier bevel protractor, or it is also called universal bevel protractor. This is the simplest instrument for measuring the angle between the two faces of a component. Acute angle, obtuse angle, other type of angle can be able to measure it by using this universal bevel protractor. You can observe over here, this bevel protractor is going to have these many components. This is the adjustable blade. This can able to slide in this particular groove. This is the main scale, and this will be the vernier scale. This will be the clamping knob to tighten to one at one position when the component is measuring between the fixed and the moving plate. The least count of this device, bevel protractor, is 5 minutes. The least count is given by one main scale division divided by number of division on vernier scale. The value of one main scale division, here it will be in the degrees. So 1 degree will be equal to 16 minute. So divided by number of division on vernier scale. The number of division on the vernier scale will be 12. So 60 by 12 will be equal to 5 minutes. That is the least count of this device, vernier bevel protractor. As compared to the normal protractors, this bevel protractor can able to measure the angles at the precision within the level of minutes. Whereas in the normal protractor, it is possible to measure only in degrees. Whereas in this, it is possible to measure even in the minutes also. It is the simplest instrument for measuring the angle between the two faces of the component. It consists of a base plate attached to the main body as well as the adjustable blade. The adjustable blade in this particular device is capable of rotating freely about the center of the main scale. So it is capable of measuring from 0 to 360 degree. That's why it is called universal bevel protractor. The vernier scale, actually it consists of 12 division on right side, 12 division on the left side. Total 24 divisions will be there in the vernier scale. So these are some of the examples of how the device can be used to measure the angle of a component between the two faces, acute angle, obtuse angle, or for these type of component, it can be easily possible to measure the angles. The reading on the vernier scale will be having small divisions. In order to amplify it, there will be a magnifying lens which will be provided so that the reading can be taken easily. As you seen in that image, it consists of the blade, movable blade. It can be either 300 mm long blade or the 150 mm long blade, which will be having 13 millimeter wide and 2 millimeter thick. You can observe here there are 12 divisions on the vernier scale starting from 0 to 60 degrees on both the sides of the zero of the vernier. You can observe here this is the vernier scale. So from 0 to 60 it will be having these 12 divisions. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So each division value is 5 minutes. So that's why if this is the third line is the one, if it is the reading, then 3 into 5, 15. That's why it is written as 15. This is the main scale reading. So this is an example of how to take the reading in the bevel protractor. So here another example, you can observe the main scale as well as the vernier scale division which is been showing here. In this particular case, for this position, you can observe here this is the zero of the vernier scale and here 80, here 80 is there, here 90 is there, this is 85. So here the reading is being taken in the in this direction, in the anti-clockwise direction. So the main scale value or the in terms of degrees it is 85. You can observe here 85, but the zero of the vernier it is little bit front to this 85 degree line. This small deflection that can be measured in the vernier scale, you can observe it has been highlighted here. So as I told, it is measuring in the anti-clockwise direction. So in the anti-clockwise from 0 to 60, these 12 divisions need to be concentrated now to see that whichever the line of the vernier exactly coinciding with the main scale. And you can observe in this image, this particular line is exactly coinciding with the line of the main scale. It will look like a single line. Only one particular division line will be coinciding exactly with the main scale. None of the other lines is coinciding exactly with the main scale line. You can observe here only this line that need to be identified. That here it is mentioned as 30. That means from 0, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 the division in the left side it is been coincided. So 6 into 5 minute it is 30. So the final value for this particular position of the bevel protractor, it is 85 degree 30 minutes. If the main scale is reading in the clockwise direction, then this 0 to 60 of this side of the vernier scale need to be considered. If it is moving the anti-clockwise, need to consider only the anti-clockwise direction in this side of the vernier. The observation, the least count of the bevel protractor, as I told, it is 5 minutes. So 60 minute divided by 12 will be, which will be equal to 5 minutes. And this will be the tabular column. For the given standard component, you need to measure the between the two faces of the component. You need to write the angles for it in terms of degree as well as minute. Now this is the procedure which will going to be followed to take the reading from the vernier bevel protractor. The result will be written. So this is the theoretical part of this particular universal bevel protractor. So now we will see the how the instrument will be actually be used to take the readings by conducting the experiment.
Hello guys, so today we will going to discuss about another experiment which is called universal bevel protractor. What you are seeing here, it is universal bevel protractor. The name it is called universal because it is used to measure the all the angles acute angle, obtuse angles 0 to 360. So in the triple M lab, this is another experiment which you are going to perform. So angle measurement using bevel protractor. And this what we discussed, the theory in the class itself, the least count of this particular instrument, it is 5 minutes. So this universal bevel protractor, it is basically used to measure the angle. It is a simple measuring instrument to measure the angle between the two faces of a component. And that component here, it is this standard component which we are going to take to measure the angle between the two faces using this simple instrument, bevel protractor. So usually it will be available in the set with a box, one with the 150 mm, another with the 300 mm length movable blade. This has to fix into this particular bevel protractor. This is the blade which does not move. This is the blade which is going to rotate along with this rotating knob. This blade has to be connected to this particular device, right? So these two pieces, now it will need to be joined together. So that will be the locking nut to lock between. So one will be fixed blade, another will be the movable blade. It can able to move freely. So in between these two blades, the component, standard component, will be kept, for which the angle need to be measured. So this universal bevel protractor, this will be the lock knob, right? And this is a magnifying glass to view the reading easily. So this will be the main scale. So 0 to 90, it will be having, right? So this, as it moves, one more division what you can able to see over here, this is the vernier scale, right? What you can see through this magnifying glass, it is the vernier. As in the theory what we discussed, it is going to have the 12 division on the right, 12 division on the left. You can count from this 0 to 60 on the right side, it will be going to have 12 division. So 0 to 60 on the left, it will going to have 12 divisions. So based on the reading, whether you are taking clockwise direction or in the anti-clockwise direction, the vernier also need to be read in the same direction. The main scale is this, it will be given the reading in terms of degrees. And this vernier, what you are looking over here, it will be given in terms of minute. The least count of this device, it is 5 minutes. So this is how the component, the standard component for which the angle which you are used to measure, it will be kept like this. So this is how the component need to be placed between the fixed and the movable blade. So as I told, the least count of this particular universal bevel protractor is 5 minutes. So least count means value of one main scale division divided by number of division on the vernier. See, the main scale reading, it will be one, value of one main scale division is 1 degree. So 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. So 60 minute divided by the value of vernier scale, that is on one side, it will be 12 division. What you can see over here, on one side it will be having 12 division, on the other side it will be having the another 12 divisions. So 60 minute divided by 12, it will be equal to 5 minutes, which is what showing over here in the on the instrument itself, 5 minutes. So this is how the component need to be placed between the two blades. Once it has been held in place, the lock nut need to be tightened. Now the reading need to be taken. So as you can see over there, for the main scale division and in the vernier scale division, there is a zero, right? With respect to that zero, we have to take the reading. Here it will be zero. With respect to that, now the main scale division reading, it will be 92 degree, right? 92 degree will be the reading. 92 degree. Then actually the division, it is in between 92 and 93. As you can observe there, the zero, it is in between 92 and 93. That small reading, that is also can be measured accurately using this bevel protractor, universal bevel protractor. The least count is 5 minutes, which is not possible in the normal protractor. Where in the normal protractor it is possible only to measure only to up to degrees, right? So here it is 92 degree. The remaining division, what it will be there, that for that you have to see the vernier scale. So in the vernier scale, as you all know that one, the coinciding line, the coinciding division need to be checked for the remaining value. So 92 degree, then you have to observe this, because you are looking in the clockwise direction. So now the vernier scale also be taken in the clockwise direction from 0 to 60. Whichever the value, it will going to be coinciding with this. That means the line which look exactly like a straight line, which division, that you have to check over here. As you can see over here, the third line in the right side direction from the zero, it is the one which will going to coincide with that of the main scale division, which will look like a straight line. You can observe this line, exactly straight line. There is a third reading. So three means, third value means it is 50 minutes. Each value will be equal to 5 minutes, right? So 92 degree, 15 minutes will be the final value for this component, right? 92 degree, 15 minutes. Each value on the vernier scale will be equal to 5 minutes. It is what shown here, 5 minutes, each value. You can observe here, 30, it has been mentioned from 0. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Likewise, up to 60, it is there. The third line is the one which exactly coincide. So because of that, third line means 3 into 5 minutes, it will be equal to 15 minutes. The final reading will be 92 degree, 15 minutes. So this is the final value for that in terms of minute. So one more reading we're going to take for acute angle. See, now the specimen is being kept to measure the acute angle. Now the reading here, you can able to see that one. The reading, what we are going to take here in the main scale, it will be 89 degree. Now in the main scale reading, it is 89 degree with respect to the zero of the vernier is concerned, right? With respect to zero of the vernier is concerned, it is now 89 degree. Here in the vernier, whichever the line which going to exactly coincide with the main scale, that you have to check. Is there any value, any reading, it will be there with respect to the main scale. If it is coinciding, that you have to verify it. As it is a line standard, always the observer has to view exactly perpendicular to the reading. Otherwise, it leads to parallax effect. So there is no reading which will going to match exactly with that one. 89 degree is the final value. As you can see in the scale, exactly the 89th division matching with the zero of the vernier. The angle it is 89 degree only, right? Like this, for acute angle, obtuse angle, you are going to measure. So another reading. So this is another place of the standard specimen which has been kept. Now we will check the reading for this. You can observe the zero of the vernier with respect to the main scale. What you can see over here, it is not 90 degree, it is less than that, right? So it is around 89 degree is the main scale reading, but in between it is there, 89 and 90. That small reading, that small deflection, that you can able to measure on the vernier scale. So now in the vernier scale, if you see the reading which is going to exactly coincide, the fifth reading in the left side from the zero of the vernier, if you can see that one, it will be the one which is exactly coinciding with that one, right? You can see here, this is the line which is going to exactly coincide, which look like a single line. So finally, the value of this, it will be 89 degree 25 minutes, right? 89 degree is the main scale division, main scale reading, what you have looked into. Then this small reading that can be measured on the vernier, whichever it is exactly coinciding. And this is the one which exactly coinciding with the vernier line, which look like a single line, as you can able to observe, right? So that fifth value, it is exactly going to look like a single line. So 5 into 5 minutes, it is 25. So finally, the reading will be 89 degree 5 minutes is what the reading for this specimen, which is being kept in between the fixed and the mobile blade. This is how the reading can be taken, the angle can be measured using this bevel, universal bevel protractor.